Mm-hmm.
Now then. Mm-hmm. Excuse me.
My apologies.
A moment of your time.
Be gone with me.
I see.
Thank you. Excuse me. Not exactly. Not. But of course. Thusly. Yes. Now then. Listen. In truth, what's in the... After that... It couldn't be. Yes. Ah, yes. In truth... Leave it to me. You have my thanks. Come now. Just so.
Call me Lucia.
Greetings.
I apologize. In truth,
why, I'll be.
Yes.
Indeed.
Correct.
Yes. I see.
Correct.
Shall we begin?
Thank you.
Is that so? Where?
Professor Albright, I apologize for this little ruse.
I'd recognize that voice anywhere. So, we meet again, Headmaster Yvonne.
When I heard you were looking into from the far reaches of hell, I knew your search would lead you here. And sure enough, you didn't disappoint me. Your mind is every bit as sharp as I thought it was.
You sent Lucia to keep an eye on me.
What a shame, my dear boy. A thirst for knowledge like yours would be such a terrible thing to waste. So, what do you say? Apprentice yourself to me, and I will overlook your little trespasses.
How kind of you. I refuse. I am, shall we say, philosophically opposed to your stance on knowledge. I believe that knowledge should be shared, not hoarded for one's personal gain.
I thought you'd say as much. Most unfortunate, Cyrus. Most unfortunate. As you know, this is my house, and I don't get many callers these days. A smart man like you knows what this means, yes? When you starve to death here, no one will be the wiser.
What have we here? Now then!
Professor? Are you okay?
You think you can get away with this?
The winds are forcing me out.
What next? Never miss it.
What's yours and mine?
Well then, may the sacred light shine forth!
What is the logical course of action?
What next? Yeah, holding back nothing. Cowering before the huntress. The hunt ends.
The wings of fortune have come.
Letting the hunt begin.
I'll not be defeated. May the sacred fire shine forth.
Letting the hunt begin.
Don't start things you can't finish.
I appreciate it. Really.
My turn now. There!
cold lightning. Smite them down.
Letting the hunt begin.
The wings of fortune have.
What next?
Nothing will stand before
me. Letting the hunt begin.
I'll do my best.
Cowering before the huntress. The hunt ends.
The wings of fortune have.
I'll do my best.
Letting the hunt begin. Begin it. I will cut an end.
Out of my way.
The wings of fortune have. It'll all be over.
Ha!
beginning.
Research on you.
The wings of fortune have
the hunt beginning. Letting the hunt begin. Watching my blow dance. The hunt ends.
Thank you.
Cyrus!
Professor...
You just couldn't leave well enough alone, could you? You disappoint me, Cyrus. I took you for a more logical man. Headmaster Yvonne, what do you intend to do with her? The girl went poking around in my secrets. I fear she can't be allowed to live. And so I'll finish off teacher and student in one fell swoop. You'll not lay a hand on my pupil! I'll see to that! You seem terribly agitated, Cyrus. It's not good for the humors. It's one of those blood crystals. You will taste the power I summoned from the far reaches of hell! I cannot fail!
Letting my arrow fly in true.
I'll not be defeated. Allow me to have a look.
What is the logical course of action?
What next?
Out of my way.
You're too close. What is the logical course of action?
Beginning. Coming, if thou darest.
Time to steal the show.
An interesting dilemma. My focus is unparalleled.
I'll not be defeated.
Letting the hunt holding back nothing. I will have a problem.
An interesting dilemma. Hold light! Smite them down!
I'll not be defeated!
What is the logical course of action?
What next?
Letting the hunt begin.
Best.
Thus ends your lesson. What in the... Have my gratitude.
Thank goodness.
Awake, are you?
Yes, Professor.
Therese, I must know what you saw and heard. You'll tell me, yes?
Yes, Professor. One day I heard the headmaster talking to someone in his office. I couldn't make out the other voice, but they were talking about you. They were saying they would see you dead. So I...
You came all the way here to warn me.
Yes, Professor.
I see. Well, Therese, as your teacher, I must scold you for your most reckless and careless actions.
I understand, Professor.
But one thing is also clear. Were it not for your actions, I would have died in that dark pit. And so, as a man, I owe you a debt of gratitude. Thank you, Therese, from the bottom of my heart. But you must promise me one thing.
What is it, Professor?
In the future, pray consult someone you can trust before embarking on such a dangerous course of action.
I'm sorry, Professor, but I did learn from the best.
I suppose you did, didn't you?
Professor, I
must continue my journey, but I will send letters. Yes, I'll include assignments to keep your mind sharp. But I think we've talked enough for the day. You should rest.
Wait, Professor! The headmaster. He said one more thing.
Hmm? What's this now?
He said that once you were out of the way, there was a place he would go.
Intriguing. And where might that be, pray tell? I appreciate your concern, but I will go there. I must. In a way, we are not so different, the headmaster and I.
Professor?
That unquenchable thirst for knowledge, bordering almost on obsession. And yet, Our philosophies regarding the ultimate purpose of knowledge could not be more different. The headmaster used his position and prestige to hoard knowledge for his own foul ends. As an academic, I cannot forgive this. Knowledge is for one and all. We inherit the knowledge of our ancestors and pass it on to those who follow us. Only then is its true value realized. Headmaster Yvonne believed true knowledge should begin and end with him. He was wrong. Always remember this, Therese. Knowledge is a bounty to be shared by all.
A bounty?
The more of us that possess true knowledge, the richer we all become. Those who seek knowledge must never forget this. That is what I believe. And those who would use their knowledge for nefarious ends must be stopped.
So, it would be wrong of me to keep this to myself. The headmaster said he was headed to the town of Duskbarrow.
I see. Thank you, Therese. Do not worry. Your teacher will not make the same mistake twice. When I act, I will exercise due caution.
I can believe you this time.
Please do, my dear girl.
If you say so, then I shall see you when you return.
You have my word. I will arrange for someone to look after you until your strength returns. Duskbarrow. Whatever did the headmaster seek there? Judging from his transformation to that dreadful beast, the power he obtained was an unholy one indeed. Is it possible that the tomb holds not only the secrets to death, but new forms of life? And yet, I find it hard to believe that transforming himself into a demon was the headmaster's ultimate goal. Did he not say he was betrayed? And the original copy of the tome is still nowhere to be found. So many questions remain. But now I know where I can find the answers. On to Duskbarrow, and whatever dark secrets await me there.